Did you know that rheumatoid arthritis is not only a joint disease? Yes, rheumatoid arthritis can damage your lungs. In this video, I will discuss the different lung complications caused by rheumatoid arthritis, how to prevent them, but also how to treat them. Let's begin.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
Hi, I'm Dr. Diana Girnita, a board-certified rheumatologist treating arthritis every day, especially people with rheumatoid arthritis. Many people, when they hear about rheumatoid arthritis, they intuitively think about a disease that affects the joints. People who are diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis usually experience joint pain, swelling, stiffness, and they go to see a rheumatologist like me for these reasons. Usually doctors make a diagnosis and propose a treatment. Some people are happy to finally have a diagnosis and they start the treatment, but many patients are afraid of the treatments that we propose and they refuse or postpone. Now, this can complicate the situation. Why? Because rheumatoid arthritis means inflammation that will slowly but surely affect other organs. Did your rheumatologist discuss with you about how rheumatoid arthritis can affect your lungs? If they did not, let me tell you more about how rheumatoid arthritis affects the lungs. The number one complication is called interstitial lung disease. And this occurs when inflammation spreads to the lungs, causing scarring, hardening of the lungs, and eventually damage of the lung tissue. Now, patients usually experience gradual shortness of breath, dry cough, and fatigue. And if this is left untreated, it can significantly impact your quality of life. Sometimes patients present with these symptoms before the joint pain starts, and the lung specialist during his evaluation will order some additional tests. Some of them will be for autoimmune diseases, and they might find out that you have a positive ANA or a positive rheumatoid factor test, which will direct you towards me, the rheumatologist. So, rheumatoid arthritis does not always start in the joints. It may also start in the lungs. The number two complication is called pleuritis. This is an inflammation of the lung lining. Our lungs are covered by a thin layer called pleura. And when this gets inflamed, it produces more fluid, which expands this layer and will cause pain. We call this pleural inflammation pleuritis. This can cause chest pain and fever, and the chest pain can be worse by taking a deep breath. When inflammation is bad, a chest x-ray may show fluid in the bottom of your lungs. Sometimes, if there is a lot of fluid, your doctor might take a sample, analyze it to make sure this is just inflammation and not something else, like blood or an infection or even cancer. Especially for patients taking immunosuppressive medications, if they have a lot of fluid in the lungs, it is best to be evaluated for the possibility of an infection, as their drugs can lower the immune system and that will increase the risk to develop infections. The number three complication is rheumatoid arthritis nodules, and these are the only specific rheumatoid arthritis manifestation in the lung, because all the other complications like interstitial lung disease and pleuritis can be seen in other autoimmune diseases. Just as you may develop nodules under your skin near the joints, you may also develop these nodules in the lungs. And I will show you an image to see how they look. They can remain in the lungs for a long period of time, and they do not give you any symptoms. But sometimes they can cause complications like cavitations. They can look like an abscess or pneumothorax. They can cause rupture in the lung tissue, which will lead to severe chest pain and shortness of breath, usually abruptly. When a rheumatoid arthritis nodule is discovered in the lungs, your doctor will recommend a biopsy to make sure that this is not a tumor or a cancer, especially if you are a smoker. Another common complication are lung infections or pneumonia. And this is again especially important for people that are on immunosuppressive medication, because if you start coughing, spitting up a lot of sputum, or even if the cough is dry, if you develop fever, chills, night sweats, or chest pain, call your doctor and get a chest x-ray, as this might be signs of pneumonia. In that case, your doctor will stop the immunosuppressive medications or biologics and treat you with antibiotics. And once the infection is cleared, you may return with your rheumatologist agreement to resume the medication. Now, some medications like methotrexate or leflunomide can rarely cause inflammation in the lungs, but there are studies that are contradictory, and that doesn't mean that you will develop a lung disease, because with proper care, proper monitoring and treatment, you may still use this medication to treat rheumatoid arthritis. Now, how to prevent rheumatoid arthritis lung disease and how to treat lung complications in patients with rheumatoid arthritis? First, the most important thing is prevention. If you have been diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis, you should discuss it with your rheumatologist and get treatment as soon as possible, as the longer your inflammation is left untreated, the higher the risk to develop lung complications. And if you do develop lung complications, you will need to see a team of doctors, like a lung doctor or a pulmonologist, that will closely collaborate with your rheumatologist. Depending on the type of lung complications, you may benefit from different types of treatments. For example, for patients that have interstitial lung disease but they do not have symptoms like shortness of breath, then monitoring every 6 months with pulmonary function test is very important. If you start developing symptoms, for example, dry cough or shortness of breath, then you might benefit from treatment with immunosuppressive medication. Initially with steroids, this is the beginning of the therapy, but then other medications like methotrexate, azathioprine, abatacept, or rituximab that can be appropriate for your case. And if all of these fail, then we have antifibrotic therapy, like the new therapy with OFEV, which might be also an option. However, all this treatment needs to be discussed with your physicians. I mentioned earlier that rheumatoid arthritis can cause a lot of lung complications that can impact your quality of life so much. But there is something that you can do besides medication only. And I have an online course that you can take from anywhere in the world that will teach you all the pillars of lifestyle changes that you need to know. All of it is scientific-based information, including nutrition, exercise, mindfulness, and I even talk about the appropriate supplements. So check this out and deep dive into the nutrition and lifestyle changes that can be so beneficial to you. So, in this way, you can improve your inflammation and reduce your pain and avoid rheumatoid arthritis complication. And obviously, you can live a better life even with rheumatoid arthritis. Another important thing is to treat rheumatoid arthritis early to stop the ongoing inflammation. So that's why you need to stay in contact with your rheumatologist. You can also watch my other videos in this channel. I have a video about rheumatoid arthritis treatment because you have to understand what are your options today. If you have rheumatoid arthritis and if you are looking for a rheumatologist or if you need to be evaluated for rheumatoid arthritis, my company, Rheumatologist on Call, might be of great help to you. If you are a resident of one of the US states that we serve, you can book a consultation today and we are happy to serve you. Our approach is personalized, very comprehensive, and we combine a holistic approach with traditional medicine. Now, I hope this video was very helpful to you and that will enhance your knowledge about rheumatoid arthritis. In this way, you can make informed decisions about rheumatoid arthritis complications and about the treatment. And if you have any comments, please don't forget to leave them in the comments section below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to learn more about rheumatoid arthritis and other autoimmune conditions. Until the next time, stay curious, stay strong, and stay informed. Thank you.
Rheumatologistoncall.com